Hello viewers, you are watching IMN and I am your host Shabir Mir. Right now I am in Rambur area, which is part of Chitral, Kailash, and I have a very special guest with me, and she is from Japan. Her name is Akiko Wada, and viewers, interesting enough is to tell you that she has married a local man 30 years back, and today she has been running some sort of welfare works in this part of the world, and we will be talking about her achievements and her social work. Akiko Wada, thank you so much for your time.
Hello, I'm Akiko Wada, originally from Japan, but I came here more than 30 years ago.
More than 30 years back, right.
Then here is 30 years. Before also I was in Umuret a few years.
Right.
So it's more than 30 years.
More than 30. Can I say that when you visited this place 30 years back, you got inspired from the beauty of this area and you decided to settle here, right?
Well, it was, nature was okay, quite beautiful, but in Japan also beautiful actually.
Right.
But people were nice.
Right.
And the lifestyle of the Kailasha people,
right,
I liked, because those days they have to do all creative things. They have to do by themselves.
Right.
Even the clothes, they are weaving and thing, you know.
True.
By hand. So that thing, that also many festivals.
Right.
And very colorful.
Right.
So that one I like, and also people are very friendly,
right,
open. So
the culture, you got assimilated in this culture,
yeah,
now 30 years down,
yeah,
the lane.
But the life is very difficult.
Right.
The life.
So, I want to ask a couple of more questions before you go back to your work, social work, and your center that you have been able to build with this assistance from your friends from all across the world. How have been you dealing with the difficult life in these areas for over 30 years, right? You have been lacking sort of electricity, then water.
Electricity. I organized the,
yeah,
small NGO,
right,
by with local people.
Okay.
So we built a hydropower house,
right.
Yeah, also protection wall and this and that. Also that one also we are doing, but
right. So how have you been visiting your country quite often, once a year,
when,
twice?
When my parents were alive, I used to go
back
once in a year or something.
Right.
But now, because of Corona, just 2 years I didn't.
Right.
Maybe next year, until next year, I couldn't. I
right. Are you able to speak local language frequently, as the local,
yeah,
people do?
Yeah, for the daily life, yeah, yeah.
Right.
Otherwise,
initially it was a big barrier in communicating with people, then?
Yeah, without language, how?
Who would help you then?
No, just my poor brain.
So great. So when did you decide to establish this center, which is?
Because you know, it was 2004,
right.
We are 2003. We started, but you know here, people like to speak gossip, but
right.
Then, but there is no meeting hall.
Yeah.
Hana.
Yeah.
And so I think meet, you know, something I want multi-purpose. You know, especially you know. Those days I also had a project for the circle library.
Right.
You know, every month, some library and a book box, you know, small box.
Right.
You know,
boxes?
I put the for children book.
Right.
Then, go to Womoret and the Biril Sri Valley, some primary school.
Donated,
put 1 month, then new box, you know,
right,
like
right.
This, you know. So after that, the project is finished. That is funded by Japan, Pakistan Association or something.
Right.
Then I have many books for children. So,
okay.
Oh, I want to use this, you know.
Right.
So, you know, library I want to build.
Okay. So you have one library here, one classroom teaching where you teach local.
I don't teach.
Who teaches now?
Yasir,
who are local
not to teach the school is there, so we are also I was providing the textbook before for free but now you know government is
supporting you
not to me to the all
yes
children.
In schools government is
before
free.
It wasn't
yes. When it wasn't free you used to provide books free of cost to schools.
Yeah.
Okay, what is the other main purpose of your center? Computer skills to provide?
No, computer is just arrived a few days ago.
Right.
Computer, because it's computer, the signal to Wi-Fi, computer is very important, but I couldn't do this.
So who have been supporting you financially over these 30 years?
It's, now getting less than that because Japan, most of, support is from my friend, private friends.
From Japan and elsewhere.
From Japan, elsewhere. Okay. So, but you don't know the fact is in Japan is not good in economy and we have another problem Fukushima or this and that. They themselves is very difficult, I don't ask these days. So I just I make up craft.
Yes.
Then with some village woman, so I sell. Then some fighter I
right.
to
earn some revenue running, out of it and spend over it. Right. So what are your future plans about staying in this part of the world and running this center?
I want to retire and I like to make a craft and think some creative thing I like.
Right.
So now young generation.
Yeah.
They are now become educated. Before it's just Rumuru has maybe not so, but in Bomboreto, big village, only 3 children going to school when I come here.
When I look at home, right.
So here now most of the children go. Right. I think something 99%, I don't know, something going to school, at least to elementary. So they have to support me, so just want to have a quiet life here.
Right. So you are enjoying your life in this small part of the world.
This
and
is
do your relatives come over here to meet you?
No, it is very difficult. It takes time. And those days, now tunnel, Rawari tunnel is open, but before it's only air. So once it's cancelled, then who knows when they can go back, so no family can.
Right. So are you happily living with your in-laws? How many are?
I like because they are very people,
friendly,
friendly, very close and sometimes too much, but but it's now Japan is this kind of, Japan used to be like here. Maybe 50 years ago, 100 years ago, but now it's something, in the city, it's getting weird.
True.
So I don't, here is better.
Right. Thank you so much, Akiko Wada. It was really a pleasure talking to you. And it's really interesting to see you settle in such a long, remote area and with local people, and you are. You are just mixed up with them and teaching them, helping them, supporting them. Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.
So, before we end this program, just viewers, let me thank you again for watching this program.
Thank you.
we owe a big thank you to Akiko as well. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.